Hello children, let us continue chapter number 8, comparing quantities. In exercise 8.1, one question is left to do. That is question number 6. Let us do question number 6 first today. Okay children? Question number 6. If 60% is people in a city like cricket, 30% like football and the remaining like other games, then what percent of the people like other games? If the total number of people is 50 lakh, find the exact number who like each type of game. So here we have a city and the people are there like different games, cricket, football and other games. Here percentage of people who like different games are given. Cricket liking people 60%, football liking people 30% and remaining like other games. So percentage of people who play other games or who like other games are, we have to subtract this to total 60% and 30%, total we get 90%, that number we have to subtract from 100%, which is the total number of people. So 100% minus 90%, it is equal to 10%. So people who like other games or who play other games are is 10%. Now each game playing people number we have to find out. So number of people who play cricket is equal to 60% of total number. Total number is 50 lakh. So 60% means 60 by 100. We can write in fraction form. 60 by 100 into 50 lakh. And this two zeros and here two zeros we cut. And then here left 50,000 and here 60. Multiplying time we get 30 lakh people. Okay children. And here next is number of people who play football. Percentage is 30%. So 30% of total number 50 lakh. 30% we can write as 30 by 100 into of means into 50 lakh. Here two zeros of 100 and this 50 lakh two zeros get cut and here 50,000 left and 30 multiplying time we get 15 lakh. So 15 lakh people like football and the rest of the people like cricket. So cricket not other games. So other games liking people are 10%. So 10% of 50 lakh. It is 10 by 100 into 50 lakh. So as in the previous cases, this two zeros and these two zeros get cut with and then 10 into 50,000 we get 5 lakh. So total you see 30 lakh plus 15 lakh plus 5 lakh we get 50 lakh people. Okay, otherwise number of people who play other games we can get another way. 30 and 15 lakh people, 30 lakh and 15 lakh you add that number, that is 30 plus 15 it is 45. 45 lakh when you subtract from 50 lakh you get 5 lakh. Okay, so this way also you can do. Method is yours and you can do any method. Okay children. Next topic is finding the increase or decrease percentage. Children, we often come across 25% of unmarked price. Of means decrease. 25% decrease on marked prices. 10% hike in the price of petrol. Hike means increase. So this way we come across the terms hike and decrease or increase. So children, here let us do an example. The price of a scooter was rupees 34,000 last year. It has increased by 20% this year. What is the price now? Here we can have the solution in two ways. One girl, Amita, said that she would first find the increase in the price, which is 20% of rupees 34,000, and then find the new price. Here we are finding 20% of 34,000 first. Okay. 20 by 100, 20% of 34,000, 20% means children, 20 by 100 into 34,000, here we are writing, so 20 by 100 into 34,000, these two zeros and these two zeros get cut with and 340 here left and 20, multiplying time we get rupees 6800 or 6800, so this is the what increase in the price. So new price equal to old price plus increase. Old price, what is the old price? It is rupees 34,000. So increase is ₹6,800. So we are adding these two prices. So we get the new price. So new price is ₹40,800. So Amida did in this method. Another girl Sunita, how did she do the answer? Children, see here she used different steps. Unitary method she used. So 20% increase means here what method used? Unitary method. Unitary method. Okay. So 20% increase means ₹100 increased to ₹120. Okay. 20% increase means ₹100 is increased to ₹120. Okay. Basic amount we are taking as ₹100 increasing ₹20. It changes to ₹120. So children, so ₹1 is increasing to what? ₹120 by 100. Okay, so ₹100 is increased to ₹120. So ₹1 increased to 120 by 100. So 34,000 will increase to 120 by 100 into 34,000. So as in the previous case, these two zeros and these two zeros get cut and 340 into 120. It is again we are getting as ₹40,800. So children, here we use the unitary method and here we used another method. So both way, any way you do, answer will be the same. Okay children. Children, now let us do an example where we have a decrease in the price. Similarly, a percent decrease in price would mean finding the actual decrease followed by its subtraction from the original price. Suppose in order to increase its sale, the price of scooter was decreased by 5%. Then find the price of the scooter. Here children, the problem is scooter price is decreased by 5%. So what is the new price? Here decrease coming day what? Whatever amount is decreased, we have to find the amount. Then that decrease we have to minus from the original price. Price of scooter is equal to ₹34,000. Reduction decrease is equal to 5% of ₹34,000. So 5% means 5 by 100 into ₹34,000. So these two zeros and two zeros get cut. 340 into 5 we get ₹1,700. So this is the reduction amount. So new price will be, if there is reduction, we have to do subtraction. Okay. So reduction, new price equal to old price minus reduction. Old price is ₹34,000 minus ₹1,700. So subtracting then we get ₹32,300. We will also use this in the next section of the chapter. Okay children. Children, now let us see finding discounts. Discount is a reduction given on the marked price of the article. Marked price, we can write the short form as MP. You can have the advertisements like 25% off, 50% off, 10% off, 20% off. So this is a method or trick by the sellers to attract the people for purchasing items. Children, if we know the marked price and the sale price, how can we find the discount? Discount is equal to marked price minus sale price. Suppose marked price is ₹500 and the sale price is ₹400. So what is the discount children? 500 minus 400, it is equal to ₹100. Okay. So discount, when you subtract from marked price, you will get the sale price. Discount is equal to marked price minus sale price. This equation you write in your notebook, the definition of discount and how to find discount, you write in the notebook. Okay children. Children, now let us do one question where we have marked price, sale price and discount. Discount percentage. An item marked at ₹840 is sold for ₹714. What is the discount and discount percentage? Marked means marked price and sold means selling price, and we have to find the discount and discount percentage. So we can have marked price equal to ₹840, SP is equal to ₹714. So discount, we have learned how to find discount children. Discount is equal to the formula you should by heart, marked price minus sale price. So marked price, you know, ₹840 minus sale price is ₹714, and subtracting time we get ₹126. Okay, children, so we have found out the first answer, discount. Now we have to find the discount percentage. We can find discount percentage using the step method, unitary method, or using formula wise. Okay, so it is your choice. Any method you can follow. So using unitary method, we write on marked price of rupees 840, the discount is rupees 126. So on marked price of rupees 100, discount is equal to rupees 126 divided by 840 into 100 percentage is equal to simplification time, we get 15%. Okay, children. So this we can do using the formula method. Discount percentage is equal to formula, you have to write discount divided by marked price into 100. We have found out the number related to discount. What is the discount number? It is 126. So 126 divided by 840 into 100. The calculation is same only. So then also we get 15%. Okay, children. Children, now let us do one solved problem. The list price of a frock is rupees 220. A discount of 20% is announced on sales. What is the amount of discount on it and its sale price? Children, list price and marked price is same only. Okay, here let us see the solution. Marked price is the same as the list price. Here 20% discount means that on rupees 100, the discount is rupees 20. By unitary method, on rupees 1, the discount will be rupees 20 by 100. On rupees 100, the discount is rupees 20. So on 1 rupee, the discount will be rupees 20 by 100. So children, on rupees 220, here the sale price, here marked price is rupees 220. So on rupees 220, the discount is equal to rupees 20 by 100 into 220. So these two zeros here cut with a 1 0 and the second zero. Now left with 22 and 2, multiplying time we get 44. So rupees 44 we are getting as a discount amount. Therefore sale price equal to, we have learned the formula, marked price minus discount. Marked price is, or list price is, rupees 220 minus 44, and subtracting time we get rupees 176. Okay, children. And another girl named Rahana did the same solution in another method using the unitary method only. Here children, discount means, a discount of 20% means for a marked price of rupees 100, discount is rupees 20. Hence the sale price is rupees 80. Okay, you know children, if marked price is 100 and discount is 20, then what will be the sale price? 100 minus 20, it is 80. So Rehana used this method. Okay, so using unitary method, when MP is rupees 100, sale price is rupees 80. So when MP is rupees 1, the sale price is 80 by 100. So when MP is rupees 220, the sale price equal to 80 by 100 into 220 is equal to rupees 176. Children, the same problem we can use the formula wise also. Discount, after finding discount, we have to find the sale price. Okay, using formula also you can do. I think it is better using formula. Okay, children. Children, let us do the same question using formula. List price is given rupees 220, discount is 20%. We have to find the discount and sale price. So discount is equal to 20% of rupees 220. So 20% we can write as 20 by 100 into rupees 220. So simplification time, zeros are get cut, and now we have left with 2 into 22. 222s are 44. Okay, so discount is rupees 44. Now sale price, you have learned the formula, marked price minus discount. Marked price, it is given as rupees 220. You know list price and marked price is same, and discount we got as rupees 44. So rupees 220 minus rupees 44, we get rupees 176. So we have seen three methods for this question. So any method you can follow. Okay, children.